Good evening, everyone, and welcome to Inside Artesian Football here on WREP 15 Sports, the opening show of the 2018 football season. I'm your host, Eric Meyer, joined, as always, by Artesian head coach Carter Whitson. Coach, again, we appreciate you joining us this year.
Thanks for having me.
It's your second year at the helm of the Artesians. Do things get any easier, a little bit easier now in year number two?
Yeah, absolutely. Year one was just trying to swim in the deep end and get a staff put together and figure out what we were going to call offensively and defensively. So it's been a little bit more enjoyable year two, feeling like that we have a little bit of a rhythm. We are by no means a well-oiled machine yet. We're still a work in progress, but we're doing well.
Really ended the year on a high note, started off the season trying to get familiar with some things, not only for the kids familiar with the offense, the defense, the coaches, but for the coaching staff to get familiar with calling plays and how to get ready and get going for games.
Yeah, absolutely. We were a young team and a young staff, especially in experience. You know, I'd been coaching for a while, but I'd never called a full game. And, you know, Coach McKinney'd never called a full defensive game for a varsity team. So, we had to learn that on the fly, which was okay. But in the same way, we all had to learn how to win. You know, they lost that over the past few years and just didn't know how to finish games, finish plays, finish drives. And once we got in the rhythm of doing that, we went on a roll.
Yeah, you're able to get on a roll. Started off the season with the four losses, but then once you got that first win, went on a roll and eventually falling in the sectional championship game. Let's talk a little bit of the things that maybe you learned from last year, some things that you're trying to change and incorporate into this year that'll help you as the team transitions to year number two.
Yeah, you know, even in year one, I had the insight of, even after we got beat by Garrett Catholic, I said, relax, guys, we made the playoffs. Indiana high school football is kind of weird. Everybody makes the playoffs. So it is about, and I have the patience to know that it is about getting better each week and preparing yourself for a tournament run. So, you know, we know that still. We're still going to stick with that philosophy. We would love to win every game instead of starting out 0-4. So obviously that's our goal and our expectations. So a little bit different, but we understand patience and new kids playing, and we're going to play some good opponents, and anything can happen.
Kids kind of got a taste of it, and like we said, they rip off six in a row to wrap up the season, getting to the sectional championship. You guys getting a taste of it as well, and the fans getting a taste of it. Also, what that means, higher expectations coming in to year two. What are your expectations for this year's
team? You know, we set ourselves some high expectations in our room, under our roof in there. Our plan is to win every game. I talked about it when I got hired here in January a year ago, or 2 years ago, that we have one goal, and that's to win a state championship. So that's what we're working for. It's our expectations. Anything else, just isn't quite good enough. So our kids believe that. They work like that. And obviously that's the goal that we have for ourselves.
Every year you lose seniors. You lose valuable seniors. You lost several last year, but you've got a talented bunch coming back this year as well. Let's talk a little bit about this year's ball club, and we'll start on the offensive end. Everybody likes offense. That's your specialty, the spread offense that we bring. What can we expect out of this year's ball club on the offensive side?
You know, we're going to look similar to how we've looked before, I believe, in the philosophy that we have. And you know, and it's the same offense I played in at Oklahoma with Sam Bradford, and the same one we had at IU with Trey Roberson. So, you know, quarterback-wise, we've got a few guys that can really play. Some of them have some different skill sets, so we'll always adapt to them. But in high school football, if you're good up front and you got a decent quarterback, you can win some football games. And I feel strong about our offensive line, feel really good about our defensive line. But offensively, we're going to be good up front. We're going to be solid at quarterback, and we've got enough playmakers to get them the ball spread across the field.
When you start talking about the offense, the playmakers on the team, the people on the line, what are some of the names, the numbers people are going to see out there making contributions, making the Artesians successful on Friday night?
Yeah, at quarterback, senior Travis Griffey, number 5, will start out the game for us. Number 8, Xavier Tinnitus, will also play. Xavier has a very high skill set and does some things really well, so I'm excited about his future. Running back, Isaac Osborne, will carry the load. similar to what he did last year with a little rotation of Tyler Cox, young sophomore that's really, really stepped up into a varsity role. We also have two more guys. We've got some depth at running back that I'm really excited about with Donovan Hooten and Ethan Potteroff. So we're going to be good at that position. Wide receiver-wise, we've got an all-conference guy back in Matt Thomas. You know, his counterpart on the right side is Andy Myers, who played a bunch of football for us last year. Really excited about him. And then slot receiver-wise, we've got Michael Hoppel, a senior, number 22. Seth Gallion, number 3, he's going to play both ways. Number 9, Brian Johnson's another senior that started. It was an honorable mention all-conference tight end last year. We've got some good depth at the receiver spot. You know, I didn't even say Garrett Miles or Matthew LaFerry. So we're pretty much too deep at every spot and really excited to see who will step up and take some of those roles.
Those are the guys you're going to hear a lot of, the guys that you don't normally hear a bunch about. But like you said, if you can be really good up front, mm-hmm. you're going to have a lot of success as that line. Who are some of the guys that have stood out thus far in preseason on the line?
Yeah, we've got 4 seniors up front that have all been fighting for some starting positions, especially on the interior. Hunter Hankins has played last year, started every game, number 58. Hunter Stout, number 78, is a center. Nolan Baker, number 76, is a guard. And Jacob Huey has filled in at every position he can and is competing for a spot still. The tackles will be Isaac Whitaker, who has really stepped up and had a phenomenal summer and camp. Really excited about him. And then Jackson Kleesner will be a third-year starter at right tackle as a junior. Looking forward to seeing some young guys continue to step up. Wesley Badger, Nigel Bryant, Jason Jenkins. These are all sophomores that can really help. Andy Baugh's in the rotation too, so we should be pretty good up front. You know, some veterans and some different skill sets.
A look at some of the Artesian offense. Let's flip over to the other side of the ball and the defense. It's a defense that last year had a lot of success, and you got a lot of those guys back again this year.
Again, you know, in high school football in 5A, it starts up front. I guess everywhere it starts up front, but, you know, we're really good up front. Defensive line-wise, we have 4 seniors that'll start. Ben Marino, number 88, and his counterpart is number 89, Chase Haviland. Those two, you know, kind of look like twins out there on the field. They're long, they're lanky, they're really good football players. Really excited about those two. And then interior-wise, Logan Byram was a starter last year, number 77, and a new starter this year will be number 72, Joey Kohler. Again, those are 4 seniors that are really explosive players, dynamic players, really excited about them. And then we've got some depth at that spot too. We've got Chris Brown's another senior that'll play a bunch. Nigel Bryant will play on both sides of the ball. Darius Cook. So feel really good about our defensive line.
From the defensive line, going back to the linebackers, you've got some guys, a good mix of mm-hmm. youth and veterans on that.
Yeah, we do. We've got, you know, we've got 3 returning starters there. And I'm really excited about the 4th starter. He'll be filling in for a senior that left us last year, but really excited about his potential. We'll see how he shows out on a Friday night. But Ben Balserac, number 47, he's quarterback of the defense, plays the Mike linebacker. Jacob Burkett plays our outside linebacker to the field. He's number 30. He'll be a 3-year starter too as a junior. So we're excited about him. And Izzy Elliott's had a phenomenal offseason and summer and really developed into a good athlete and a better linebacker. He's number 41. And then at the other spot, you know, we've got some few guys that are competing for the job. Weston Pemberton's a freshman that doesn't look like a freshman. We're really excited about him and his future. And Zach Petty's a senior who can rotate at all the different spots, can even put his hand down and rush the passer, good blitzer. We're really excited about Zach, too.
Then you move to the secondary with the safeties and the corners. Again, a pretty good mix of guys coming back from last year and working in a few new guys as well.
Yeah, corners are 2 really good football players. One of them was all-conference, the other one should have been if we could get that many on the all-conference team. Number 6, Garrett Miles. Really good player, again, a senior, playing both sides of the ball, kind of our longer, a little bit more physical guy. Really, you know, he's going to be a phenomenal player. And then on the other side is Seth Gallion, number 3, senior. Again, he's playing both sides, probably will start both ways. He'll be the only guy doing that. He's an extremely hard worker, stays in shape. He's a guy that everybody trusts, knows he's going to get his job done, and, you know, he's a lockdown guy. You know, rotating in with those guys, if we go a little different package, Billy Bias will really step up and help us out there. Adam Fields, a sophomore that we expect good things out of. Larry Bland's a sophomore we expect good things out of. And then at safety, you know, we've got a few different packages we can do. Andy Myers played quite a bit of safety last year. He'll play some this year, but he's going to be mainly an offensive guy. The guy that will start at safety for us Friday night will be number 44, Will Nix, a sophomore that played a little bit of linebacker last year, played with the freshmen, played on the varsity, played some special teams. He is a downhill, knock-your-head-off kind of guy. Really excited about him. Look out for number 44 making some violent collisions on Friday nights.
That's what we need, guys back there hitting, and he will bring. You got a lot of young guys, got a lot of guys with experience, so you have to feel pretty happy about where you are right now anyway, offensively and defensively.
Yeah, you know, we're just so far ahead of where we were last year. You know, I feel like last year we were installing still at this point, and now we're cleaning things up. You know, we all know what to do. We've changed some terminology, which has been easy. But, you know, it's nothing that's crazy different. A lot of these guys are back both sides of the ball. But it is. We're to that second chapter. We're to year two. Kids know it. They can learn more so they don't have to relearn everything. So, yeah, we're really excited about that.
You also throw in the third facet of the game, which is special teams, and have a special kicker on the team. Also, Caleb Urban back once again to handle your kicking duties.
We might have should have started with him. Caleb is a preseason All-State guy. Was really good last year, made every one of his extra points, hit a few field goals over 45 yards. He's a phenomenal kicker, very high skill set with kickoffs and onsides and field goals and extra points, and also scored 4 goals last night in their soccer game, so he's a great athlete. I'm excited about Caleb. He'll do some punting. Travis Griffey will do some punting. We've still got a little bit of an open job at the deep snapping spots. We've got two guys that are really stepping up and competing with Trevor Moskrip, a sophomore, and Sam Lyde, a freshman. So excited about those guys, and we'll have them for a while. Craig Wesner will step in as the holder last year, replacing Darius Stillman. He's a guy that we trust to do the right thing with the ball and can take care of it, and Caleb really likes him holding it for him. So, excited about special teams. It should be a well-oiled machine there.
Like you said, we've got some veterans, a mix coming back, some new kids that'll move in, offense, defense. A look at the special teams as well in the 2018 version of the Martinsville Artesians. All right, well, let's go look ahead now. We've got a game coming up on Friday night. Before we get to that one, though, let's just take a look at the schedule as a whole. Like you said, Indiana football is a little strange because everybody gets to make playoffs. We're in already. A little bit different than other places than where you played growing up. So it's about getting better. Your schedule-wise, a few changes on it. Some new things as well. We've got a new Mid-State Conference and a new opener. We'll get to the opener in a second. But as you look at your schedule overall, what do you take away from it? What do you like? What things are you trying to gain as you get going towards that postseason?
Yeah, looking at our schedule and looking at our conference, it's completely different than last year. A lot of the staffs, there were a few staffs in the conference that were completely new. So obviously they're going into year two like we are, and you're going to be better year two. So I know there are a few last year that were in the rebuilding phase like we were that will be better. So I expect our conference to be extremely competitive. And it's different. You know, you play Whiteland, you play Decatur Central. Those are two completely different teams. So you're going to see a little bit of every offense and every defense in our conference, which is fun and good and sets you up to compete in the playoffs and for that tournament because you don't know who you're going to draw there.
You also look ahead for non-conference. Well, you've got a new conference, though, in Perry Meridian this year, and the non-conference the same in Bloomington South, the team that you guys have always battled traditionally. Battled in the sectional championship and maybe there again. A new team on it, though, is the team you're going to open up with on Friday night. That's Bedford, the Bedford North Lawrence Stars. So let's talk a little bit about Bedford and what we can maybe expect out of them. Let's start on the offensive side of the ball on Friday night.
Bedford is a team very similar to us. They bring back a ton of starters, a lot of seniors. So I think we have 23 seniors. I'm not sure how many they have, but if you look at it and you watch their film and you look at their playmakers from last year, they're all back. So I expect Bedford to be very, very competitive in their conference. It will be a dogfight week one. We know that, playing at their place. Very well-coached team by Coach Weber. They kind of start out and finish out with their quarterback. Last name's Ray. He's a good player. They run the triple option or veer option and really try and get the ball in his hands. I got a few guys that are back that play the slot backs, and their running back is back, number 88, which is kind of weird for a running back, but he's a good player. So, you know, they're going to run it, try and throw it a little bit, but they're going to try and live and die by the veer. So we've been preparing for that for a while, and you know, it'll be a big time challenge.
When you flip over to the other side of the ball for them defensively, what are you going to see out of them to try to attack your guys' offense?
You're going to see an odd defense, as in odd front. There's going to be three down linemen, and then most of the time they'll rush a fourth, either from the boundary or from the field, and it kind of turns into a 4-4 defense, which is what we play. It just looks a little bit different pre-snap on where they can come from, so it gives them some flexibility. But you'll see them play a bunch of cover three most of the time, very similar to us. Again, a handful of guys that are back as starters. I know 44 is one of their interior linebackers that's a starter. Number two plays the outside linebacker. They got a safety, 3 and 5, that are good players that, you know, are veterans now. So, you know, they'll be well coached, they'll be well disciplined, and pretty good on defense.
Well, let's ask a little bit. We usually get this at the end of the show, but we'll ask here the keys to the game. What are you guys going to have to do to try to come out with a victory in game number one?
Yeah, these will sound pretty cliche, but it really matters in week one is we have to stop the run. You know, they're going to run the veer, and we have to stop it. We need to stop the dive back, and we need to tackle the quarterback. Stopping the run, stopping the quarterback is our whole thought process on defense. We got to tackle well in the open field. They run a good enough offense to where they're going to make some plays, but we can't give up too big of plays. And then offensively, we need to take care of the football. We need to finish drives. You know, we win 2 or 3 games of those 4 we lost last year if we just finish some drives. You know, when you've got a 12-play drive, that's hard to call every perfect play and execute every perfect play. So we need to finish with some bigger plays and not have to dink and dime the whole way down and grind it out. We need to have some explosive plays that we started getting at the end of the year last year. But taking care of the football, you know, regardless of what the weather is, we might have a little bit of rain. So that will maybe determine a little bit what we need to do. But taking care of the football, stopping the run, as cliche as those are, they really mean something for us this week.
The keys as you head down to Bedford to battle the Stars on Friday night in the opening game of the 2018 football season. You've had a couple of other things go on throughout the summer as well. The kids have been in here an awful lot practicing. You had the red-blue scrimmage. You had the controlled scrimmage on last week against Columbus East. Just take us back before we circle back again on how some of those things have gone and how things have went for you guys over the summer.
Yeah, now off-season started for us about 2 weeks after we got beat by Bloomington South. So we had a phenomenal off-season in December and January. And then we have most of our guys play a second sport in the springtime, which is good. I always like that for them to get away from me, and I like to get away from them a little bit too. So that was our leading up into summer. Guys running track, guys playing baseball. And people don't realize that we're there. We started June 5th, and we get 12 padded practices in the summertime, and every other day we're working out. So we had a great summer, very good attendance. We can't make it mandatory, but winning isn't mandatory either, and these kids have bought into that, and they're there. They're working hard. The staff's working hard. So, you know, we're quite a bit ahead of where we were last year, week one. But these kids have, you know, they've never shied away from working hard, and you could really see it this summer. You could see some physicality changes that you'll see some guys like, geez, he's a lot bigger. Wow, he's a lot stronger. And so they've done a good job of that this offseason.
Getting ready for the opening game of the year, also getting ready for that long grind as they head towards the playoffs with Bedford North Lawrence. Coach, as always, we appreciate you joining us. Good luck, as always, on Friday night. We'll see you down there.
Appreciate it. Thank you.
That's Artesian head coach Carter Whitson here inside Artesian football. The Martinsville Artesians open up the season with a unfamiliar opponent in the last couple of years. We've played Bedford in the past, but not for several years. So the Artesians will travel down to Bedford North Lawrence. Get out early because you want to beat the traffic down there and help support the Artesians, rain or shine, against the Stars of Bedford North Lawrence High School. Coach, as always, we appreciate you joining us. We'll see you again next week. For the head coach, Carter Whitson, along with the kids in the advanced broadcasting class who produced it, I'm Eric Meyer. We'll see you again next time inside Artesian football. Yeah.
All right, here we go.